Wyoming. Hi, Annette. Boy, it must be beautiful in Wyoming this time of year. How are you?
Oh, I'm fine. Thank you. We were having a discussion, and the question came up. We were sort of meditating on the St. Michael prayer, and God loves us so much. So the question was, why would he allow the devil to prowl around the world, the earth, seeking the ruin of souls, instead of casting him into hell as we pray all the time? And then the other question was, would we would still have free will if there were no devil to tempt us, right? I guess, so there's a two-part question in there.
Well, the reason God allows evil, we know that, is that a greater good can come from it, that God would never allow the devil to seek the ruin of souls to do us harm, but to give us opportunity to counter the devil and in ways that we wouldn't otherwise, and so that we end up loving God more than we would have otherwise, because it brings out more love from us, because it's difficult. You know, it's difficult to do, and that's why. And I don't remember what the second part was.
Would we still have free will? There would still be free will,
certainly. But it's the same. It's like the crosses we have in our lives. You know, why does God allow us to have these crosses? Why can't we just be, you know, why can't it just be easier? Because the crosses, again, are hard, are difficult to do, and they bring out the best in us. We end up expressing greater love than we would have otherwise by the energy or the effort it takes to counter the evil. That's why God allows us, because he wants the best for us. And you know, it's God. It's not like man acts. Does God act? God's ways are so different from ours, but his ways are perfect.
Does that help you, Annette?
It does. That's a much better answer than any of us came up with. So thank you very much.
Great. Thank you. Awesome.